prisoner for the Lord, then, I urge you to live a life worthy of the calling you have received. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. That's what it means to be faithful to your calling. And to his spiritual son, Timothy, he advises in 2 Timothy 1:5-6. I have been reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother Lois, and in your mother Eunice, and I am persuaded now lives in you also. For this reason I remind you to fan into flame the gift of God which is in you through the laying on of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power, of love, and of self-discipline. Timothy the evangelist, the spiritual son of St. Paul, Timothy was called by God. He was taught by his grandmother and his mother, who were both Christians, and his gift was affirmed by the church in Paul's prayers and the laying on of hands. Our church is sending out a member to a new mission, First Baptist Church at Big Stone Gap. We're sending out our sister Sarah Clevenger, who is assuming the role of campus minister at UVA Lawrence, following June Colley's 33-year campus ministry in college students. I believe this is a calling from God to Sarah, and she will bless and inspire those college students, especially the young women on that campus, which make up a majority of Baptist Student Union, who face so many challenges in our society. And I've been the faculty advisor to the BSU, now the BCM, Baptist Collegiate Ministry, UVA-wise. I've been the faculty advisor for about 20 years there. And I've seen the tremendous impact campus ministry has had on these young people during the years of college when their faith is challenged. Their faith is often attacked in that college. And they face trials and decisions of early adulthood that will affect the rest of their life. Jim Colley's been an extraordinary campus minister to those students, going through these very severe challenges of life, challenges to their faith. Well, Sarah's being appointed by the Virginia Baptist Mission Board, but she's coming out of our church. We should pray for her and send her off as the church in Antioch prayed for Paul and Barnabas. So I'll ask Sarah to come up and pray for her and anoint her, and ask any of you who will join me to pray for her in this new mission field, this vitally important ministry that she's blessed to have. And I know that God has called her. God's going to bless her. God's going to bless those students through her. So we rejoice. Hallelujah. The privilege of praying for her, praying on hand, sending her on for this important mission. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you, God, for calling our sister Sarah to this important campus ministry. I know, Lord, that she's a bit nervous about following in the footsteps of that great campus minister, Jim Colley. But she has and only needs you, God, the guidance and comfort and encouragement and help of your Holy Spirit. So in your name, Lord, this church anoints and blesses her as your scripture advises to empower her gifts, music and counsel and prayer. prayer in this campus ministry. We thank you, Lord, for your mercy and goodness. We ask you to bless her and use her for your kingdom. Lord, use her to touch these college students, these young people, whose faith is non-existent or is under attack, whose society is full of wickedness, licentiousness, temptation, evil. Lord God, use her to minister to them, give her wisdom and words to them, kindness and gentleness, as we heard Paul say in our ministry, kindness and gentleness and mercy of Christ. Protect them, guide them, and use them.